Okay, guys, now we've got yes, no, not given. Yes, no, not given means I give you a good tip for that. If the statement agrees with the passage, answer is
true.
Yes. True kithon aa gaya? And if the statement disagrees with the passage, answer is
no.
And if sanu nahi pata, tuhanu vi nahi pata, then it is
not given.
These are silly tips. Okay, now let's go on. Let's see what is it that we got to find. Question number 34. The difference between true, false, not given and yes, no, not given is, in true, false, not given, you have to check factual information. Factual information. In yes, no, not given, you have to check writer's view, writer's opinion or writer's claim. And I tell you, it's written there. Please come. Questions 34 to 39. Do the following statements agree with the views of the writer? Underline that. Views of the writer. And please come back. True, false, not given. Come back. Questions 1 to 4. Do the following statements agree with the information given in reading passage? Information given means facts. So for factual information, true, false, not given. And for writer's view or claims, yes, no, not given. Okay, question number 34. Forsyth's finding. Now, you know this word already, this person. Forsyth's finding contradicted previous beliefs on the function of fractals in art. Now, look here. If Forsyth's finding contradicted, contradicted means they were opposite. If his findings contradicted previous beliefs, the answer is
yes.
If Forsyth's findings actually, what do you say, supported the previous beliefs, then the answer is
no.
Contradicted means opposite, and supported means actually it's the opposite to that. Then it is no. And if they don't tell us whether Forsyth's finding contradicted previous beliefs or they've supported previous beliefs, then the answer is not given. Now please come back to the passage. Look for the word Forsyth. Third, last paragraph, and you will find it there. And by the way, the good news is, in truth, yes, no, not given, also questions and the passage, they are
in order.
In order, yes. So, have you found this word, yes. Forsyth?
Yes, sir.
Third, last paragraph.
Third,
last paragraph and fourth line, Forsyth. What's more, now please, let's read about him. Kind of perceptual overload according to Forsyth. What's more, now this is what he's saying. Appealing pieces, both abstract and representational, show signs of fractal, repeated motifs recurring in different scales. Fractals are common throughout nature, for example, in the shapes of mountains, peaks, or the branches of tree. It is possible that our visual system, which evolved on is he saying anything? That Forsyth's findings contradicted previous beliefs. Not given. Exactly. Right? So, question number 34, answer is?
Not given.
Yeah, aapko nahi mila, tab bhi not given kar dijiyega. Huh? Alright, just joking. Answer is not given. Now, question number 35. Now, you will see, there are the next two paragraphs. So, five answers you will find there. The good thing is, question number 35. Certain ideas regarding the link between mirror neurons, underline mirror neurons, underline certain ideas, link between mirror neurons and art appreciation. Now, one thing is mirror neurons and second is art appreciation, require further verification. Look here. Further verification means further, for verification, they need to investigate further. Right? So further evidence is required. Now please come. Second last paragraph. Have you found the word mirror neurons?
Yes.
Fourth line. I'm reading this line. Please follow me. This may be down to our brain's mirror neurons, which are known to mimic others' actions. The hypothesis will need to be thoroughly tested. Future. Will need to be thoroughly tested. Now, will need to be thoroughly tested means they require further verification.
Yes,
well done. Require further verification. Now, underline require further verification in the question and in the passage. need to be thoroughly tested or will need to be thoroughly tested. Right? Question number 35, answer is
yes.
Question number 36, people's taste in paintings depends entirely on the current artistic trends of the period. People's taste in painting and depends entirely. Now focus the word entirely. Same paragraph, third last line. While the fashions of the time might shape what is currently popular, works that are best adapted to our visual system may be the most likely to linger once the trends of previous generations have been forgotten. People's taste in painting depends entirely on the current artistic. Not entirely, because they mentioned one more thing, may most likely to linger once the trends of previous generations have been forgotten. Still they linger on. Now over here they say entirely, so it's not entirely, it's partially. So what is the answer?
No,
exactly. Opposite of entirely actually is just like partially. So this word is good for yes, no, not given, or true, false, not given. Okay, question number 37. Scientists should seek to define the precise rules. Now underline scientists, define precise rules which govern people's reactions to work of arts. So scientists should define the rules, the rules which govern people's reaction to work of art. Now please come to last paragraph. Second line. It would, however, be foolish to reduce art appreciation to a set of scientific laws. Set of scientific laws. What does that mean? Precise rules. And he says it would be, however, foolish. And come on, not given. Keda not given, Allah, huh? Listen, try to understand. Scientists should seek to define. Now I say, you should try to go to Canada. And there I say, it is foolish to go to Canada. Right? Now, scientists should seek to define the precise rules. And keep in mind, you are checking writer's views. Writer's views or writer's claims. So please read again. Question number 37. Scientists should seek to define precise rules. That's what he's saying, that scientists should define the rules which govern people's reactions to work of art. Now let's read it again. It would, however, be foolish to reduce art appreciation as a set of scientific laws. Set of scientific laws means rules. So what is the answer?
No.
Why no? Because in the question he says scientists should do that. In the passage he says it is foolish to do it. That's why. Yeah. Question number 38. Art appreciation should always involve taking into consideration the cultural context. Art appreciation should always involve. Underline the word always. This will define whether the answer is yes, no, or not given. So if, for example, what is the opposite of always? Sometimes, occasionally, in certain situations, right? So art appreciation should always involve taking into consideration the cultural context. Please come to this after this foolish one. Yeah. Third line. We shouldn't underestimate the importance of the style. Are you there?
Yes.
We shouldn't underestimate the importance of the style of a particular artist, their place in history and the artistic environment of their time. We shouldn't underestimate. What's the question? Art appreciation should always involve taking into consideration, should always involve, and we should not underestimate the importance of style, right, of particular artists, their place in history and the artistic environment. For that they use the word cultural context in which artistic artist worked. So the answer is
yes,
not true. Please, if for yes no you write true false, your answer will be wrong. And many students have done this careless mistake. How many questions are there? 6 questions. And how many answers are yes no? Yes, no, kitne answers aaye abhi tak? हमने अभी तक 38 तक किया है ना, राइट? सो चार आए हैं. सो इफ दीज फोर आंसर्स आर रिटन ट्रू फॉल्स, ये चार के चार गलत, ठीक है? तो वहां पे एक काम कर लीजिएगा, इट्स इजी, ये जो येस नो नॉट गिवन है इसको इनसर्कल कर लीजिएगा ताकि ज़ेन मेरी, या बड़ा सा वहां पे लिख लीजिएगा उस पर येस नो नॉट गिवन, ठीक है? ताकि समझ में रहे कि इसको यूं ही ऐसे ही लिखना है. येस नो का प्रॉब्लम है, नॉट गिवन का कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. क्वेश्चन नंबर 39, इट इज ईजियर टू फाइंड मीनिंग इन द फील्ड ऑफ साइंस देन इन दैट ऑफ आर्ट. Easier to find meaning in the field of science than art. Last two sentences. In some ways, it's not so different to science. When he says it's not so different to science, where we are constantly looking for systems and decoding meaning so that we can view and appreciate the world in a new way.
Yes.
Try to understand. In some ways, it's not so different. It's not so different. And he says, it is easier to find meaning in the field of science. Easier to find. He says, it is not different. When it is not different, it means it's not easier or difficult. So the answer is? Exactly. Not given. Try to understand. I come to it again. Actually, over here, they are using comparative. It is easier to find meaning in the field of science then in that of art. They are comparing science and art. Whereas when you come to the passage, no comparison is given. They say in some ways, it's not so different to science. What are they talking about? Science. Have they mentioned arts?
No.
Science, where we can constantly looking for systems and decoding and all that. Have they mentioned arts?
No.
Have they given any comparison?
No.
So the answer is?
Good.
Ho gaya. Awaaz rakh. चुपके रखो आवाज, ओके? काका ठहर जा. ऑलराइट, नाउ लास्ट क्वेश्चन प्लीज. या इन दो मास्क लगाए, इन हेलमेट पा के बिठाया कर क्लास जी. ओके, क्वेश्चन नंबर 40 प्लीज. चूज द करेक्ट लेटर ए बी सी और डी, राइट? नाउ फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन नंबर 40, यू विल नॉट गो एनी वेयर इन द पैसेज. यू विल जस्ट यूज योर ओवरऑल अंडरस्टैंडिंग. This type of question, question number 40, it is called global multiple choice. Try to understand. What is global multiple choice? Global multiple choice is a question that covers all the passage. Global does not mean international. Global means a question that covers all the passage. Now let's see what is the question. What would be the most appropriate subtitle for the article? I give you 30 seconds. Aram se, tasalli se. Then you tell me. For that, you can go back, read the title, keep in mind all the passage, right? Very good. All right. Okay. How many of you say D is the right answer? ठीक हो गया, इसको बाहर निकाल दो. D को आपको नहीं, आप क्लास में ही बैठे. How many of you say C is the right answer?
No.
Okay. आप नीचे कर लें, 40 नंबर आपकी किस्मत में नहीं था. How many of you say B is the right answer? All right. आपका भी गलत हो गया. And how many say A is the right answer? Yeah, मैं तो पहले ही किया सी. A is the right answer. Some scientific insights into how the brain responds to abstract art. Now listen. They have mentioned B, C, D also from the passage. But B, C, D is actually covering a small portion of the passage. Whereas A covers all the passage. Because you know they use the word, what would be the appropriate subtitle for the article? So B, C, D, other three options, they cannot be the subtitle. They can be the title for a paragraph, but not for all the things. So for question number 40, A, some scientific insights into how brain responds to abstract art, that will be the right answer. Okay?